So today we're going to take a look at some what we consider for our class advanced circuits. In short, that means looking at the individual circuit components. Now, for the classes that we're looking at, we primarily look just at resistors. It's usually the AP levels that start looking at things like capacitors and inductors and so forth. But that being said, the principles of what we look at are still the principles that apply to those circuits. So of the ones we're going to take a look at, a couple part problem here. I've got one that says that there is, let's see, they've got a drawing that looks a bit different from mine. I'm going to update it to look like mine. So they've got a battery that looks like this, comes around, and we have a split into two resistors, like this. It says a 25-volt battery has an internal resistance R, little r. They put a resistor here. And we didn't talk about this directly in class. Again, this is usually a bit more for the AP class. The AP class would deal with this a little bit more. In real life, batteries don't let charge through them perfectly. It's not just an open door for charge. It's actually a little difficult to get charges to move through the battery. That's one of the reasons why in the labs that we did, when you hook them up to different things, their numbers will change slightly, and a lot of that is actually because of the internal resistance. In short, for our purposes, I put a little green box around it because this is all technically inside the battery, but you can totally forget that. In short, whenever you're dealing with an internal resistance, it's a real-world thing. Move. It's a real-world thing, but you would just consider it immediately in series with your battery, either before or after. As we've seen in circuits, because the charges have to always be moving through the circuit, you end up with, it doesn't actually matter if the thing is before or after in the circuit, because one change to a circuit changes everything about the circuit, usually. So the information that we've been given, at least for me, is 25 volts for my total battery potential difference. We've got 18 ohms for one and 63 ohms for the other. And the question is, what is the resistance of this resistor, little r? The last piece of information that they give us is, I've got here, they're saying that the total current is, oops, not zero, it is 1 amp. I was thinking it was 0.1 amp for 100 milliamp. Okay, so we need to try and find the resistance there. The drawing in this is actually a little bit different. They've got something that looks more like this. This is actually the same thing. Come on, smart board. Battery. Wire that goes over to a split. One resistor. And another resistor, both of which in parallel, comes back together, goes through here and up through this single resistor and back into the battery. They look a little bit different, but these are actually both the exact same circuits. As we talked about, circuit diagrams can get a little confusing until you get used to them. There are a number of different ways to draw kind of the same thing. And in real life, this probably wouldn't look like either of the circuit diagrams because you'd have wires that kind of go all over the place. The stuff we use in class makes it look a lot more like this. I try and keep it like this because I think it's easier on the eyes. So what we've got here is, well, this is a complex circuit because we've got a bunch of stuff happening with many different types. But we do know that our total potential difference is 25 volts and our total current is 1 amp because this is what will go through this unknown resistor and go into the battery, which means 1 amp is coming out here. It is splitting. Some of it goes this way and some of it goes this way, but the total is 1 amp. So if I were to do this with my diagram, hard for me to do this on this page as opposed to what I normally do in class, which is on the other board, but let's go with total. Let's go with resistor A, B, and then little resistor R. We've got some information. We know that our total potential is 24 volts and our total current is 1 amp. Now, as a reminder, this is using the technique that we learned in class. Delta V equals I R. In this case, total is for the entire circuit. The potential difference from the battery, which is supplying the potential for our entire circuit, is 24 volts. We have a current of 1 amp, and therefore our total resistance must be 24 ohms. 1 times 24 equals, well, 24. V equals IR. delta V equals IR. We know that the resistance of resistor A, I'll call this one A, for me is 18 ohms, and resistor B is, look at that, 63 ohms. We want to know what this one is. All right, so here's where we can work through a little bit of this. We can use equivalent resistance. We know that A and B are in parallel, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and combine these to find the equivalent resistance of these. The equivalent resistance, Req, is going to be equal to 1, oops, sorry, these are in parallel, so 1 over the equivalent resistance is equal to 1 over 18 ohms plus 1 over 63 ohms. Now, let's see, let me get my calculator. I should have come prepared for this, I apologize. But, all right, in the essence, to try and keep this what I promised you in class before, I'm going to do this adding fractions, even though I'm going to regret it. I'm going to do the lazy one. You can probably find a better common denominator, but I don't actually care. I'm going to multiply this term by 63 over 63. So 18 times 63. This one turns into 63 over 1,134 ohms. Plus, I'm going to multiply this by 18 over 18. That gives me 18 over 1,134 ohms. Simplest way to get a common denominator is to basically cross multiply. But that's not actually cross multiplication. I apologize. I'm multiplying by the other values. 63 over 63 gets me this, and 18 over 18 gets me this. If I multiply 1 over 18 by 63 divided by 63, 63 divided by 63 is just 1. And mathematically, I do not change something if it's 1, or if I multiply by 1. This, you can plug into your calculator, you'll find it'll be the same thing as 1 over 18. That being said, I can add these together, and we find that 63 plus 18, that'd be 70, 81, if I'm doing this correctly, over 1,134 ohms is my equivalent resistance. I'm sorry, this is 1 over my equivalent resistance. So I'm going to take 1,134. Let's see, 63, good. 1,134 divided by that value, and my equivalent resistance, Req, is 14 ohms. Great. So I know that this is 14 ohms, and it is now in series, my equivalent resistor, with R, and my total resistance is 24, so that means 14 plus the unknown equals 24, which means R, apparently, must be 10 ohms. Let's double check. They have something a little bit different, 11 ohms. Let me double check my values on here. Yep, they got the equivalent resistance of 14 ohms. Oh, I'm sorry, I wrote this down wrong. Foolish Sanchez. I wrote it down right here, 25 volts, but then, like a fool, I wrote 24 there. 25 volts, which makes this 25 ohm. Which makes this, if this is 14, when we do the equivalent resistance, this is not 10, it is 11, which is the actual answer. Look at me, I make mistakes too. All right, so that got us that. Let's look at the second part. They say determine the magnitude of the current through the 63 ohm resistor in the upper left of the circuit. Well, real quick, there's a bunch of different ways that you could go about this if you'd like, but here's what I'm going to do. We know for this circuit that all of the current, the 1 amp, is going through our unknown resistor, which we now know is 11, so that's 1 amp through there. Delta V equals IR, 1 amp times 11 ohms. I can find that there is 11 volts, that is the potential difference, across this internal resistance in our battery, which is actually quite a bit. That's not great. Anyway. By loop rule, I can now gain 25. I'm going to start on the far end of the battery, go up 25. I go down whatever is over the 63, and then I lose whatever's on this resistor. So 25 minus VB minus 11 has to come up to zero, which means my potential difference across resistor B must actually be 14 volts. By the same token, you can go through resistor A and you'll find that it has the same potential difference drop. So while we're here, we might as well solve the whole thing. So 14 volts equals our current through B times 63 ohms. So I'm going to take 14 divided by 63, and we end up with, interesting, 0.222 repeating. That should be our answer. Let's double check. And that is what they have listed. So there we go. And for completeness, because it's only one more step, 14 divided by 18, 0.778. Basically 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7. But that's fine. Adding these two together, they'll actually come up to pretty much one, which is what we end up with. So here we go. There's all the information that we could want about our circuit. We're using our table approach to analyze a circuit.